friends, I am Meenu Jain. In this video, I will talk about design and calculation of cascade aerator, which is generally used in water and wastewater treatment for removal of odor, gases, iron, excess carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide and methane by mixing the air into water. These are some key points related to the cascade aerator. Cascade aerators consist of series of steps that allows water to fall in thin layer from one level to another, where aeration is accomplished in splash zone and the exposure time of air to water is increased by increasing number of steps. Area volume ratio could be improved by adding baffles to produce turbulence, but the major operating problem include corrosion and slime and algae buildup. Circular and rectangular are two main configurations which are generally used. Aeration equipment is used to intentionally mix air and water so as to facilitate the transfer of gases into or out of the water. So, cascade aerator is used for intensively mixing of air in water. It is necessary for surface water where natural oxygen content was depleted due to presence of large amount of organic substances, for removal of dissolved iron and manganese, because iron and manganese are oxidized and form nearly insoluble hydroxide sludges. They can be removed in settling tank or by means of coarse filter. And cascade aerator is also used for removal of excess carbon dioxide to prevent corrosion of metal and concrete surfaces and reduction of hydrogen sulfide, methane and VOC and other volatile compound which produces objectionable taste and odor and also used for temperature reduction. Now comes to the design criteria of cascade aerator, where surface overflow rate is 0.02 to 0.05 meter square per meter cube per second. Total height of aerator is 1.5 to 7 meter. Height of steps or rise per steps is 150 to 300 mm. Length per steps for rectangular arrangement is 300 to 600 mm. Inlet water velocity for central pipe is 0.6 to 1 meter per second because of the gravitational flow. So, for designing calculation of cascade aerator, inlet flow rate is assumed as 50 cubic meter per hour. So, as discussed, surface overflow rate which is used in between 0.02 to 0.05 square meter per cubic meter per hour. So, the average for this calculation, I have taken the average value as 0.03 meter square per meter cube per hour. So from this surface overflow rate and inlet flow rate, we can find out the surface area of cascade aerator. So surface area of cascade aerator will be flow multiplied by surface overflow rate. That will be 50 meter cube per hour multiplied by 0.03 meter square per meter cube per hour. That will be 1.5 meter square. So discharge velocity of water, which I have taken 1.2 meter per second. So area of discharge pipe will be flow rate multiplied by discharge velocity. That will be 50 divided by 3600 multiplied by 1.2 meter per second, because the inlet flow rate was in R and the discharge velocity was in meter per second. So we have I have divided 3600. So the unit it will so we got the unit balance. From this calculation, we got area of discharge pipe will be 50 divided by 3600 multiplied by 1.2 meter per second. That will be 0.01667 meter square. So from this area of discharge pipe, we can find out the diameter of discharge pipe by square root of area multiplied by 4 by pi. So that will be 0.200 meter or 200 mm. So diameter of central pipe will be 200 mm and central shaft wall thickness will be approximately 200 mm. Thus, outer diameter of central shaft will be 200 mm for central pipe plus 200 for one side thickness and 200 for other side thickness. So that will be total 600 mm. So the 600 mm will be outer diameter of central shaft. So from this diameter we can find out the area of central shaft, that will be pi by 4 multiplied by diameter square, that will be pi divided by 4 multiplied by 0.6 square. Here we have converted 600 mm to 0.6 meter, that will be 0.28 meter square. Total area of cascade aerator will be total area of central shaft plus surface area of cascade aerator. So we have calculated the surface area of cascade aerator as 0.28 meter square and total area of central shaft is 1.5 meter square. So we will sum up and got 1.78 meter square as total area of cascade aerator. Thus the diameter of cascade aerator will be square root multiplied by 4 by pi multiplied by area, that will be 1.6 meter or 1600 mm. So as conclusion, we got total area of central shaft is 1.5 square meter, total area of cascade aerator is 0.28 square meter, diameter of central inlet pipe is 200 mm, and diameter of aerator required is 1600 mm or 1.6 meter. But for the detailed calculation, first we have to calculate the steps height and width. So for height of rise per steps, from design criteria, rise per steps is 150 mm to 300 mm. So we will take here 150 mm. So number of steps will be total provided head divided by rise per steps. So that will be number of steps will be 1500 mm divided by 150 mm, that will be 10 steps. So our number of steps will be 10 number. And for width of steps, so width of drop will be total diameter of cascade aerator minus outer diameter of central pipe divided by number of steps, that will be width of drop will be 1600 minus 600 divided by 10 multiplied by 2 because of the both side steps width, that will be 50 mm. So width of drop will be 0.050 meter or approximately 50 mm. If total diameter of cascade aerator is 1600 mm and outer diameter of central shaft is 0.60 meter or 600 mm, then we can find out the diameter of our steps from this. So diameter of first step will be diameter of central shaft plus width of drop multiplied by 2 because of the both side width, that will be 600 mm plus 50 mm multiplied by 2, that will be 700 mm. Note, width of drop is 50 mm, and for both side calculation we have multiplied by 2. Likewise, we will calculate diameter of all 10 steps. In similar way, we can calculate the diameter of each step. So diameter of first step will be 700 mm, second step will be 800 mm, third 900 mm, for fourth 1000 mm, fifth step diameter will be 1100 mm, sixth step diameter will be 1200 mm, seventh step diameter is 1300 mm, eighth step 1400 mm, ninth step 1500 mm, and diameter of 10th step is 1600 mm. This is the schematic diagram of designed cascade aerator, which is having 10 steps followed by collection chamber at bottom of aerator. Here all the dimensions are given for each steps. This is the process animation where water comes from central pipe and passes to each step and get aerated due to increased surface area. And finally collecting in collection chamber at the bottom of cascade aerator. Now comes to the calculation of collection channel around the aerator. So for the calculation of channel around the width of cascade aerator, design flow will be again same as 50 meter cube per hour. Channel width by diameter ratio will be 1 and velocity will be 0.6 meter per second. So calculated width will be square root of flow rate divided by velocity divided by width divided by diameter ratio. That will be square root of 50 divided by 0.6 multiplied by 3600 multiplied by 1. That will be 0.2 meter. So calculated liquid depth will be 0.2 meter or 200 mm. So provide for collecting channel width will be 0.2 meter because width by length ratio is taken as 1. So liquid depth is also 0.2 meter or 200 mm. So width and liquid depth both will be 200 mm. This is the top and front view of designed cascade aerator. These are some references used in designing of this aerator. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe for more videos related to water and wastewater treatment calculation and theory. Thank you so much.